Hi everybody, my name is Matt Elliott. I'm here at the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon today to show you a rig we just got. It's a brand new, beautiful Tiffin Wayfarer 25RW. Now Tiffin is a manufacturer that's well known for their quality of craftsmanship. They build all of their own hand-built cabinetry. They start everything from the ground up. They build especially where the cabinets, they have a magnificent shop, and they build everything in their lineup from this coach all the way up to the, you know, very, very expensive high-end diesel pusher buses with the same quality of craftsmanship. That's what makes this such a special rig. The other thing is it's on a Mercedes chassis, and the Mercedes is what everybody is seeking for. First of all, they get really, really good fuel economy. A typical RV gets maybe 8 or 10 miles to the gallon, and this thing will get as well into the mid to high teens, let's say between 15 and 18, depending on what kind of a lead foot you are. Now, the other thing is a Mercedes, it's got all these really, really great safety features that a typical coach doesn't have. Like, for example, this has adaptive cruise control, which is gonna keep you from having, as you're traveling on the highway at speed, if the vehicles in front of you slow down, your vehicle's gonna slow down too to compensate so you don't run up on people or have an accident. There's a lot of other stuff that Mercedes does that's different than other coaches. Other chassis in the industry. Okay, now as we look down the line here, we're gonna see all these really cool things that Tiffin does. First of all, this is an absolutely beautiful coach. Full body paint, alloy wheels, and I wanna point out that we have a full fiberglass front enclosure, but it doesn't hang way out over the front end of the coach where it's difficult to see street lights and things up above. You've got a really good view. You can see up above the coach just fine. And it's very aerodynamic. Even these side cabinets here are sloped back. Instead of most coaches, you'll see a 90 degree angle here. And that means that you get a lot less wind noise, a lot less drag, and a lot less of that. You don't have to yell at each other when you're driving. You can have a nice conversation because it's not so noisy. Out here, we've got beautiful TV set outside under this awning. We have a brand new style awning. This is a Girard, and it's a power awning, and it's very attractive. They've got patio lighting out here. We've got frameless windows. These are beautiful, and they're big, so you get a lot of light in there. I want to show you here. So this is the compartment door, and most coaches that you see, these are fiberglass panels that are laminated together, and they don't have the longevity and the durability that Tiffin has with this kind of a door. And my dad's got a boat that's older than I am made out of this same stuff, and it looks like brand new. And of course they work really well, close beautifully. We've got over here this little guy. That is an exhaust panel for our diesel heating system. This coach doesn't use any propane. It's really a new kind of technology from what you're used to in most RVs. We've got both electric and diesel heat, and this is a diesel burner. It's very quiet, very ambient. I don't have that noise of a forced air furnace. It's not as noisy. And also, it gives me very good control over my thermostat inside the coach and also my water system. So that is a wonderful design, something that you're gonna love learning about. You're gonna see that we have that, remember I was talking about the front enclosure? We have the same thing on the back. Most coaches, the back panels are not enclosed in an end cap. They're just a panel across with a seam on the corner. But this is a fully enclosed deal. And then also, the roof, which you can't see from here, but the roof is a molded fiberglass crown. Most coaches will have a flat sheet of fiberglass that's nailed down all along the top, creating many holes and seams on the top of the coach. Or it may use, other RVs may use a vinyl or rubber top, but this is far superior to those things. It's very, very strong roof, and it is less likely to ever have a leak. So let's take a look around here. You can see that we have a slide topper awning on this coach, and that's gonna keep debris off the top of our slide so we don't have problems when we bring it in. And look how big this slide out is on this coach. This is a full wall slide, and when we go inside, you're gonna see how spacious this coach is. In fact, let's go do that right now. All right, so here we are inside the Wayfarer 25RW from Tiffin, brand new. So one of the things you're going to notice about this, even though it's a pretty small coach, is that it's got a lot of room. And the way they do that is we have a full wall slide. This is one big slide that goes from here all the way back. And so I get a lot of elbow room. I know a lot of folks that travel with pets and things, and they're always looking for a little extra floor space. This really does a nice job of that. This booth dinette here is great because, first of all, it opens up here for storage. And second of all, it doesn't have any posts where my feet go. So I can get in and out of here with my big old feet, and I don't have to wrestle around those posts. This sits on a traveler on the wall, and when it's time to make a bed, this just slides down into place, which is great. Now, also with this design, we have this couch, and it's very comfortable, but there's something else that's really cool about this couch. So let me show you how this works. Okay, I've got a queen walk around bed in a 25-foot coach. That's really hard to come by. And so this is a much more comfortable bedding arrangement. People love this, and of course, when I'm not sleeping, I don't need a bed until bedtime, right? Get it out of the way, and I have a really nice couch to sit on. A lot of coaches don't give you that versatility. So that's a watchword. If you're in a small RV, you got to be more efficient about how you use your space, right? And this is a great example of efficiency. Okay, so let's take a look at the galley in this coach. First of all, I want to point out the cabinetry in this Tiffin, in the galley and throughout the coach, is beautiful. They hand manufacture their own cabinets, mill all their own materials, and finish them themselves. They really, really do a good job on each coach. Also, I want to point out we have a beautiful window here, and it really lets in a lot of light. And you know, it's kind of funny, you wouldn't think of it, if this wall was just solid here, it would seem much darker in this coach. So I like it a lot. We do have recessed lighting throughout these areas too, and they're very attractive. Solid surface countertops, great big stainless sink, induction cooking. So one of the things that's kind of interesting here is that this is electric heat, and you can cook without using any open flame in the coach. It's a lot safer. And of course, this coach has lithium ion batteries. It has 300 watts of solar. It has a diesel generator. It is literally a rolling power plant. It's got a 3000 watt inverter system. So you can do all of this stuff in the coach just from your battery supply, even if you're dry camped, even if you haven't turned on your generator. So it's very, very cool. Also, look at these big giant drawers. This one's really special because we've got a cutting board built in, and then I can slide that back and there's drawer underneath. So that's dynamite. And of course, we have a wonderful convection microwave, so I can use microwave or I can bake. Down here, we got a lot of storage, and so that's great. You always need places to put stuff. This coach certainly has it. Now, this refrigerator is really special because look how big it is inside. Most coaches have a lot of hardware in the back to accommodate propane cooling. This doesn't have any propane cooling. It's 12 volt. I can leave this on when I drive, and since I don't have all the propane stuff back there, I get a lot more room in my refrigerator, and I think that's dynamite. Now let's take a look here. We've got a TV set located right across from our couch. Remember, this is a couch here. I didn't put the cushions back when I put the bed up, but there's a couch. So I've got a place to sit and watch TV, and even more great big giant drawers. You can look up there. And right up here, all of the controls for my inverter and my battery monitors and my generator and my solar controllers, all that stuff is put away up in here. It's very attractive because you don't have a lot of bells and whistles all over the place. And then we pull this up, and here again, another big storage area with adjustable shelving and hanging storage. Now take a look at this bathroom. Down here, on every coach you look at, you have a high step to get over the to get over the into the shower. You have to step up over that. This is the first time I've ever seen a coach with a floor level shower access. So if you have hips or knees or any problems like that for mobility, this is the one to get. Also, we've got a retractable shower curtain here. So I can pull that out, put it away, and it cleans itself when it goes away. And then I've got adjustable shower. And one thing this has that's great is it's called a water miser. And what it does is it prevents the water from coming out until it's at temperature. If you're dry camping, you have a little limited water, and you also have some limitations on your water storage. So why shoot all your water out when it's cold? Wait till it warms up, and that's what this does. Now we have a beautiful porcelain toilet, and it's located, I want to point out, it's located so your knees don't hit the wall. And then we've got beautiful counter space, a nice basin, lots of storage up above here, and a wonderful lighted mirror. So it's a really spacious, comfortable bathroom too. There's only one thing we want to do now is take a look at the cabin area up here in the front. Okay, up here in the front in the cabin area, this is a Mercedes. It's got all the new stuff Mercedes offers. It's got heated power seats. It's got all the safety features like adaptive cruise control, and it's got a big display navigation system and all kinds of cool technologies that you can only get if you get a Mercedes. I'd love to show you this coach in person, and I'd be happy to answer any questions you have about it. So if you want to give me a call, that's okay. My name's Matt Elliott. You can reach me at 541-954-8495. Thanks for watching the video. You have a great day.